and my sincere thanks to Dr. Anil Agarwal and Dr. Devan Gupta, who has invited me to speak on this subject. Till this point of the time you are studying or you are listening to what is how the brain death is. How the brain gets diagnosed, how the organ is preserved, what is the history, and what are the tests usually performed. I'm coming to the legal aspect and why we are discussing this. Reason being that this brain death is considered equivalent to death of the individual. And now the brain stem death is accepted as death of the brain. So each brain stem is dead, but that individual is dead.
Yeah.
Because each individual's brain is considered to be the death of the individual and brain stem is considered the death of the brain. So if brain stem is dead, it means that individual is dead. So this is why we are concerned, we are testifying this death centuries and all this. But the definition came in 2014, I think this is the best definition for death has come. That is permanent loss of capacity for consciousness and all brain system functions that cannot resume spontaneously and will not be restored through interventions. So if there is some injury to the brain which is not going to recover either spontaneously or by therapeutic intervention, so those patients are supposed to be brain dead. And if they are brain dead, by legal definition, they are dead. So, what the Indian context is important, why we are discussing, because we have the three definition and three are different. That is one, registration of the birth and death act, 1969 versus, and another is the Indian Penal Code, which is long back published, that is 1862 and is still in the practice. And now the transplantation of human act, that is 1994, which was earlier modified by in 2011 and subsequently 2014. So I'm coming one by one what the legal aspect is. But this registration of birth and death, and which is still practiced now, that is defined death as a permanent disappearance of all evidence of life at any time after life birth has taken place. Means that is evidence of life. So what is the evidence? Because we can assume that every cell and every tissue is alive. So if brain is dead, certain tissues are still alive. So how the holistic death can be defined? So a person whose brain stem is dead and whose breathing is supported by the ventilator and heart is beating would be considered to be alive under the Registration of Birth and Death Act. And not all evidence of life has lost. So for this definition, that is cardiopulmonary arrest is the definition of the death. And if still in the death certificate, we are never writing that, because if you are writing it, that has the legal implications that these patients will not be getting the claims. So section 46, that is the Indian Penal Code, what says, and it is published in 1862. This is that denotes death of human being unless the contrary appears from the context. So that is again the brain death has not been defined in the Indian Penal Code as well. So we are discussing here the organ retrieval and other things, and at the same time still we are confused what is death. So subsequently the Organ Transplantation and Human Act published in 1994, and what they say that brain stem death is the state at which all function of the brain stem have permanently or irreversibly ceased and is so certified under section of that act. So what they are saying, if brain stem is dead and if that is certified under this section, they are dead. But unfortunately, this has not come under the birth and death registration certificate. So I know that what are the early death, from where we have taken these definitions, that is uniform, though in 1981, when there was a miscarriage came into the practice, that is one 18 years girls who was little bit thicker, versus the undergarment, she was not fitting into that. So what she did, that she started fasting and taking that drugs of, that is diazepam that time, to lose the weight, and she took the gin, and she has been found unconscious. She was, CPR was done, and she, then her father and others said that, She was put on the ventilator. She was not awakening. The father and hospital administration said that she is not alive for ventilator to be switched off. But the attorney of that state claimed that if you remove the ventilator from this patient, we will sue parents as well as hospital for homicide. So that case went to the Supreme Court and other cases. So finally, the President Commission was constituted and the death from the America that has been taken before the Oxford criteria. So in America, that is, they published the Oxford criteria in 1969, but initially it was examined by the President Commission and this came into the practice. So an individual who has sustained either irreversible cessation of circulatory and respiratory function or irreversible cessation of all function of the entire brain, including the brain stem, is dead. So what they are saying in US, the definition of brain death is entire brain, including the brain stem. Whereas we are talking about the brain stem. If brain stem is dead, that is brain is dead, and if brain is dead, we are talking about the patient is dead. So what the Indian law says, that a deceased person means a person in whom permanent disappearance of all evidence of life occurs by reason of brain stem death in a cardiopulmonary sense at any time after live birth has taken place. So that is very important, that is live birth has taken place. Brain death is not mentioned in the death certificate as there is no provision for it, and death is always mentioned as cardiopulmonary death, which is universally accepted for the cremation, burial and the insurance claim. So still we are certifying the brain death, but still what we are writing in the certificate, that is cardiopulmonary arrest. That is, Dr. Devendra Gupta has already taken this part, that is, who can certify the brain death? So there is a brain death committee and there are four members. One is the hospital administrator or his deputy, one a specialist, and another is a neurologist or neurosurgeon, and under whom the patient care is. This has been further modified that in 2011 and 2014, they have included at the place of the specialist that an adept physician, anesthetist and intensivist. So that is anyone that is either the specialist or anesthetist or physician or anyone other person who is expertise available, they can certify. So that is the core of the four members committee has to certify the brain death. So transplantation of the human organ at 94 says that it is a statutory sanction of the brain death concept, and it regulates the removal, storage and transplantation of the human organ for the therapeutic purposes, prevents commercial dealing of the human organs. And to certify that, there is an irreversible thing you have to certify. So how to certify that whatever changes happened in the brain, that is irreversible. And we took a certain criteria to certify that it within 6 hours or something in adult patients. We have taken the arbitrary criteria for certifying that within 6 hours, if the changes are the same, the patient may be declared brain dead. But who has given this 6 hours? So to determine, in this condition, we have to determine the cause of the coma, exclude the memory kind of what that is interlock syndrome, Guillain-Barré syndrome, vegetative state, and so many things, and object the patient for a period or time to exclude the possibility of the recovery. So we don't know that is brain, how much time is going on. Recently there is one study came from the France. They had gone to the slaughter house and they had taken the head of the pig, and after 4 hours, they found that there is a cerebral activity in the pig is stopped. So we don't know at this point of the time at what time point the cerebral function is returning. So interval of what the law says, that interval between the two evaluation for the confirmation, it depends upon the age. That is term to 2 months old, that is 48 hours required for the two examinations. But if they premature baby, we are nowhere, we can't declare their death. Because there is nothing in the law. If 2 months to 1 year, that is 24 hours, and if more than 18, that is optional hour is the 6 hours. So no examination can happen within 6 hours time. So criteria for determining the brain death, that is irreversible cause of coma, absence of brain stem functions, and apnea, and two examination with interval according to the patient age, and ancillary test. Though ancillary test is not mandatory, but depending upon the certain age factors, ancillary test is mandatory. So a serial test can be used when uncertainty exists about the reliability of the parts of the neurological examination or when the apnea test cannot be performed. So if turns to 2 months, at least 2 confirmatory tests is required. So the butt ancillary test, core ancillary test that Devendra Gupta had listed, that is if you are performing within 2 months of the age, then 2 confirmatory tests you have to perform. And 2 months to 1 year, 1 confirmatory test, and above 1 year, that confirmatory test is not required. So in some words, ancillary tests are used to shorten the duration of the observation period. The interpretation of each of these tests requires expertise. So that is not everybody is expert to read the TCT and cerebral angiogram. So you need to expert to read this. In adults, ancillary tests are not needed for the clinical diagnosis of brain death and cannot replace the neurological examination. Documentation that time of brain death is documented in the medical records. Time of death is the time of arterial CO2 reached at the target value. What have target value, that is 20 millimeter above the baseline, or what the target, that is more than 60 millimeter of mercury, it has fixed. So that is the time when the carbon dioxide, that is the time of the death. In patient with an aborted apnea test, the time of death is when the ancillary test has been officially interpreted. So when you have given, suppose that some test has been given and given to the radiologist to interpret, that is the time of death. When a radiologist has given the opinion that this is the brain death. So in India, we have opt-in system. That is, if you have to test the brain death, you have to take the permission from the guardians. So you have to take the permission also for doing the test. Refusal of donation by the next of the kin after brain death diagnosis is often the biggest hindrance for organ retrieval, and brain death is accepted only in the context of the organ donation. So if someone is not willing to donate, brain death test cannot be performed. If family of a brain death declared person agrees to donation, the step outlined in organ transplantation act for declaration of brain death are followed. Organs are retrieved after which the ventilator is turned off. But if they say no to donation, there is no standard of care listed in the act. So that is, once you are retrieving the organ, once you have retrieved, you switch up the ventilator, you extubate the patient. But after performing, even they are given the consent that the brain death information test could be performed, and later they decline to cannot switch up the ventilator. The patient you have to treat as like a live individual. So there is a lack of clarity when relatives have not consented for organ donation. There is of the public mistrust also on the healthcare system. Some relatives fear that the patient has been declared brain dead for the purpose of organ donation, and clinicians are reluctant because there is so much litigation about these things, they don't go ahead for the brain system testing. And so in simple conclusion, brain death in act will support physician to declare brain death and will be legally empowered to withdraw support if there is no consent for organ donation. So what is a lacking in our that is act in 1969, that brain death certification has not been included. If it is included in the birth and death registration, then it can be done. What I need to establish that the 2 regulatory bodies have been the appropriate authority for licensing hospital to conduct the transplant operation and authorization committee to prevent commercial transaction between the donors and recipients. So this is the form what Dr. Devendra Gupta was showing, and here is one issue that is I want to highlight, that in form consent form, parents for organ donation their child less than 15 years. India says that we are mature at the age of 18 years. So if a baby dies less than 18 years, above the 15 years, from whom we have to seek the permission? That is lacking in the definition. So that needs to be addressed. Role of appropriate authority, that is they are the licensing authority to provide the authority to the hospitals for the organ, to perform the transplant and other things. I want to come to the authorization committee that is constituted to power it approve or reject the transplant between the recipient and unrelated donors. The primary duty of the authorization committee is to able to establish that the unrelated donors are not under any undue pressure, influence of the monetary consideration
have to donate their organs. So that is not a monetary game, because the effigation committee has to establish. Effigation committee meets regularly and they have to find out unrelated donors and recipient if they are their true affection. So why they are donating? I don't see that the person who has not seen any person, he has a true affection for that. So there is different interpretation, that is by the effigation committee, by the donor and by the physicians. So what class says, if any donor authorized the removal of any of his human organs before his death, not being a near relative as is specified by the donor, the reason of affection or attachment towards the recipient or for any other special reason, such human organs shall not be removed and transplanted without the prior approval of the effigation committee. So if they are not close relative, the organ cannot be retrieved until unless effigation committee is approving. But what said this Karnataka High Court? There was a writ petition in Karnataka High Court, that is effigation committee has rejected the appeal of a recipient that they have the donor. So what they said, there is no provision in the act which prohibits the person who is not near related by definition from the donating his kidney. They have mentioned for the kidney, but it is for the organs. Merely because of the near relative had not been considered as donor by the family for transplantation. And the committee has misdirected itself in its regard while refusing permission to the petitioner. And their purpose is to just establish the true affection of the donor towards the recipient. So that petition was approved and the rejection of the authorization committee was disapproved. So the clinician feels that, how the clinician perceives this about this act, the clinician feels that when the law itself provides a clause to help people whose own family members refuse to donate or those who do not have a fit or matching donor, why should they refuse any arrangement between the donor and recipient? And the plight of the recipient overrules all objections and it is difficult to understand so-called true affection. And the onus of the responsibility to find true affection and relationship rests under the purview of the government, and government has constituted the effigation committee. So effigation committee has to find out that is the donor and recipient has their true affection. And what the donor says, that instant affection to a stranger who is willing to donate his or organ for money, but they usually deny that such dealing has happened. And effigation committee now suggests that all interviews should be videographed so it can be produced when there is a required law is requiring it. And effigation committee interpretation, what they say, that recipient and donor, if they place affection, why should effigation committee object unless there is complaint for some gross oversight? So that is, everybody is analyzing this effigation committee and act according to their wish. Physician is analyzing differently. The donor, those who are getting money for certain reasons, they are analyzing differently. And the recipient, that is the effigation committee, is analyzing differently. So what the Mohan Foundation recommend for such problems? They say that the required request law that would make it compulsory for the hospital staff to ask for organs in event of brain death. So that is every time there is a brain death, that should be law that the hospital staff should ask for the organ donation. And the mandated choice of organ donation clause in the Indian driving license. So once they are given the driving license, there should be option that the person is after brain death donating the organs or not donating organs. So that once they are rushed to the hospital, that is clear that the physician committee and physician and other parties over. And undertaking post-mortem examination during the same time as organ retrieval surgery in the medical legal cases. Because once you have put up the ventilator and it because of the trauma, then again this patient is exposed to the surgery for the post-mortem. So what they suggest, that if we do the same time in the operation theater only, then it is better for improving the donation. And delinking the hospital where organs can be retrieved from the hospital where they can be actually transplanted. Because many hospitals, they used to have to declare brain death, but they can't retrieve the organs. So they patients should be transported from one hospital to another hospital, rather than what they say that this should be delinked and the team should go to that site even the hospital is not recognized for the organ donation and retrieval. So the whole team to go there to retrieve the organ, so it should be delinked. And making it compulsory to appoint transplant coordinator in the intensive care, so if in case of any brain death that come into the play and they are more skilled to communicate so they can manage better. Thank you for your patience.